I've not had that many funny looks since I went to that fancy dress party as Winnie Mandela. Do you remember? That gave me a rare insight into what it's like to be a foreign black lady travelling on a tube train full of Sheffield Wednesday supporters. What was it you went as?
Peter Purvis.
We really used to push the bow down in those days, didn't we?
Oh, thank you so much. I really appreciate this.
Well, I know we spend most of our time slagging each other off, but I'm always there for you when you're sick.
Tis, milk of magnesia, is it?
Yes, it's a new kind. Well, I'll bring it off to bed.
Have you tasted it?
No. Mmm, it's quite,
quite flour and watery, isn't it?
Sorry?
You've just made it yourself out of flour and water, haven't you?
Yes. My wallet fell out the hole in my dressing gown pocket.
Oh, tragic.
I only just found it in the hall. Bit of luck, really.
Gary, when you had flu last month, I went to 20 different shops to get you that Airfix model you wanted.
I know you did, and thanks for that. No night.
Gary, if you're not out of that door in 20 seconds, I'm going to tell Tony about your wart.
Oh, maybe I shouldn't have been managing a restaurant anyway.
What would you rather do?
Well, actually, I'd like to work with children.
Oh, well, in a sweet shop, that sort of thing.
No, primary school teacher or something.
When you were at school, did you ever get the teacher to write those long, wobbly words on the blackboard like Mississippi so you could watch the body parts sort of jiggle up and down?
No.
No, nor did I. I'm just saying that's the kind of thing that you'd have to put up with.
Oh, well, maybe not teaching then.
Yeah. Well, I'm looking for something new. Maybe we should start a company together.
What happened to your record business?
Oh, just collapsed, you know.
It's the recession, isn't it?
No, I came back one lunchtime and half the stall had collapsed and smashed most of my records. Hey, I'll tell you what you could be.
What?
A model.
Oh, don't be so stupid, Tony. They're all 18 and 5'10".
And straight up, you could.
Oh, that is the most transparent flattery I think I've ever heard.
But really, honestly?
No. Do you really think so?
Trust me.
Why did you do that?
Well, you're lonely and I'm lonely and, hey, in this big city, people like us have got to stick together.
Oh, bullshit. Tony, I thought you said you mended that bloody fence.
Oh, well, I don't have to now, do I? We'll just make love and fall asleep naturally.
No, Tony, we were just kissing. Anything?
No, not really. Gary came back, but he had to pop out again.
It's 3 o'clock in the morning.
Yeah, just can't seem to settle tonight. Has Tony forgiven you for laughing at his hair?
Yes, I think so. He's actually quite sweet. Maybe I should give him a chance. You're back.
Yes, I wanted to get to know the real you this time.
What is it you're wanting?
I'd like a barbecue set, half a pound of amphetamines and an emergency photo album, please.
What sort of barbecue set?
I was joking.
I know. You're indigestion, right? 2:35.
How much are the big loofers?
How's it going?
Great.
Me too.
You've got a crisp bag in your hair.
Cheers, mate. What's this?
Oh, I got this out. Scandinavian.
We're here. Song of the Woodcutters.
Yeah, well, there's still a chance I might start humping at some stage.
Hey, aren't they great?
Yeah.
Could watch chicks sleeping for hours. So peaceful. Hey, do you ever pull the bottom lip over the top lip when they're asleep? Oh,
that's good. I do this to Dorothy, though.
That's good.
You have to remember to put it back before the morning, otherwise you'll find out that.
Oh, yeah, right? I know what she's dreaming about.
I don't know, it sounds good.
Sounds
like make me your big toy, Gary.
Yeah, it sounded more like turn. Give me your bone, turn.
You're not asleep, are you, Dorothy?
Nope.
Fantastic.
Here we go.
I got you that stuff for your indigestion.
Oh, it's okay. I feel better now. Thanks anyway.
Don't mention it.
Now I'm starting to wake up.
I'll just take your clothes off so you don't get too hot in the bed. Maybe not.
Tony, what do you think you're doing?
Oh, go on, I'm here now.
All right.
Great.
And Tony?
Yeah?
Touch me and you'll die.
Okay.
Oh, you're only saying that because you know I want to now.
You're not getting anything unless you take your milk and magnesia.
Look, I'm the one that should be angry. I'm scared to go to sleep in case I wake up with my top lip up over my forehead. Go on. I'll be quick.
Don't be disgusting.
Ha, 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 ha.